What's up, guys? So I'm here with another Q&A, and you guys wanted a part two, so I'm gonna go ahead and do it. Sorry it took so long, I don't have any excuse for that, really, but anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and do it right now. Now, before I actually start, thank you guys so much for 4,000 subscribers. I can't believe I actually made it, you know, in a short amount of time. And this month, like July, well, probably in July no more, but July has been a fantastic month for me, and I can't thank you guys enough for that. So, anyways, on to the Q&A. Not really sure what will be in the background, but anyways, first question comes from Blaze. Any other games you play besides The Walking Dead and The Wolf Among Us? Well, I do play Garry's Mod on PC, you know, Left 4 Dead 2. Borderlands 2 is great. Payday 2 on Xbox. GTA 5 on Xbox. I also love Fallout New Vegas on PC because the mods are just amazing. And then we have Don't Starve, which is like a, you know, survival game, which is downright awesome. So, I love the crap out of all those games. And yeah, I do play other games, so... Anyways, next question comes from Vegito. He's asking, if you could bring back one dead character back to the game, who would it be? Not really sure if I answered the question before, but it would definitely be Mark from Season 1, Episode 2, was it? Yeah, Star for Help. He brought everybody some food and he laughed off that, so he's a definitely nice character, and he was like a cool, like, bro to Lee. He was like Kenny was to Lee, but back then in Episode 2, so definitely Mark was kind of trustworthy until he told Larry about what we called him, and then, you know, he missed that bird, but he was still pretty nice and helpful, so that's all that counts, really. Anyways, next question comes from Action. Do you think there will be a DLC where you play as Kenny after he escaped the walkers in Season 1, and when he met up with Sliri and all that stuff? Now, definitely that would be a, you know, number one choice for everybody, because we don't know how he escaped. It was basically, he got lucky, so there needs to be some explanation behind that, because right now, it's just bullshit to everybody, but obviously there is ways he could got out. Whenever he was in the alley with Ben, then when he was in that room when he saved Krista, everything else. So that needs to be actually explained. I want to see how he got out of Savannah, and how he met Sarita, and how he got up to, you know, Matthew and Walter. That would be like a chance to actually get to know Matthew better, because Nick killed him off. So that could be a chance to actually talk to Sarita, talk to Walter, talk to Matthew, and get to know more about them, because they're actually dead now. So definitely, that would be a great choice for DLC. Next question comes from the Super John. If you had the choice to save Ben or Sarah, who would you save? That is a, you know, one-sided answer, because I didn't like Ben. I only saved him in Season 1 just because of Clementine, so definitely Sarah. I know Sarah's more of a, you know, kind of messed up person in the head. She's kind of traumatized and everything. She has panic issues and can't really, you know, handle herself. But at least she isn't a fucking liar like Ben. I don't like Ben. He was just a shitbird, to be honest. Anyways, definitely would pick Sarah. Anyways, next question comes from Ellis. If you had to choose which video game you would be in, The Walking Dead or The Wolf Among Us? The Walking Dead is a sad thing. The Wolf Among Us is action and, you know, everything. Not really sure. Do I want to survive against walkers in The Walking Dead, or be in The Wolf Among Us, be a fable, have my own story, and then, you know, have an apartment where I'm struggling to pay rent, and then eventually I run out of money and the Crooked Man comes to kill me, okay? So definitely, I would pick The Walking Dead. I would take my chances to get the walker, because I can fight for my survival. The Wolf Among Us, if you run out of money, if you go in debt to Crooked Man, you're done for, it's over. So I'll take my chances in The Walking Dead universe. Okay, so he also asked, who would you choose to be in your group? Now definitely, I would be the leader, okay? Okay, I'll be the leader. And then we have Jane, she'll be the co-leader. We have pick Mike, Vince, Clementine, of course, and Lee. Most badass group ever, okay? Okay, so you also asked this question, I'm gonna reword it. If you had to choose for someone to die in The Walking Dead, who would you choose? Definitely Luke. He shouldn't have touched Jane. I told him not to touch Jane, and what does he do? He touches Jane, so he would die. Not a single question asked. So then he asks, who would you like to meet alive, Lee or Bigby Wolf? Now, Lee, he was a college professor, so, you know, he's a cool dude and all, but, you know, I don't mess with that. Anyways, I definitely want to hang out with Bigby because he's a bit more interesting. He has, you know, a whole story. He used to do stuff, and I definitely want to hang out with Bigby. Now, a question coming from Brave. What if Clementine died? How will you feel? Now, definitely, I'm attached to Clementine. I really love her character, and in Season 1, I want to protect her as much as I can. I did most of the good choices so she wouldn't think of me as a bad person, you know. I killed Danny first, but then she saw that and I was like, no, I'm sorry, I redid that. And then, like, you know, that's how I feel. I felt that I want to protect her and everything, and now playing as her in Season 2, you want to actually, you know, see her story. You see what she's going through and everything, and you wonder, is she going to die? Probably not, but you know, Telltale never know them, but they probably won't kill Kumatan because she has money in the banks for this game, so I hope not. I really hope not, you know. I would definitely feel so sad. I'd cry my heart out because she's such a good character, and I would really hate to see her die at the end of season two. That would just do me in for this game, and you know, it's really sad thinking about it. Like, will Clementine die? You think about that, and you're like, she can't die. She's Clementine. And then once it happens, which probably won't happen, you cry your heart out, and you're like, man, fuck this game. Clementine's dead, and it makes you feel sometimes. Anyways, on to another question, and just happens to be about more sadness. So, do you think season two ending will turn out to be sad? Now, we heard the teaser from Endale, or however you say that. He do teaser for the, I think, ending music for season two. It sounds sad. It sounds the fucking depressing. I hope it's not depressing, but season two might just end depressing. Hopefully, it's not Clementine dying. That would be too predictable and too sad. So hopefully it's something like, hey, all everybody that she was with is dead, and she just sits down and starts crying away, and then you know it ends off right there. So hopefully she don't die. I really hope not, because that's depressing. That ain't sad, that's depressing. And I hope she don't die at the end of this season. I don't think I answered your question, but yeah, it will be sad, and there is no happy ending with Telltale and The Walking Dead. Okay, so off of the depressing questions, Gamer Girl asks, picking Jane every time, eh? Who would you rather kill, Jane or Jersey? Now, that's the mistake you just made, okay? You put up my most liked character against my most hated character. And then picking Jane every time actually canceled out, okay? So you trying to play me, you trying to play me? And that ain't gonna work, okay? So you know I ain't gonna kill Jane, okay? Picking Jane every time only means in good, happy situations, but no, you put her up against my most hated character in any Telltale game possible. But anyways, I'm just playing with you. You know, I won't kill Jane. You people are evil sometimes, man. Anyways, next question coming from Jaws, asking, do you even like Sarah? Because I really hate her. Now, you should be ashamed of yourself for hating that girl. She was just a little scared girl who has panic issues, and you hate her for that, okay? It's not her fault, but yeah, I do like Sarah. She had problems, but I wanted to help her out, like teaching her how to shoot, which really wasn't used at all, which is very disappointing of Telltale. Why did they not use that? But still, I wanted to, like, you know, just shape her up the way Clementine would, make her feel better, make her understand this is how the world is, things like this happens. And I was hoping that she would understand later on in the story, and then just, you know, start to man up a bit, but that wasn't the case, and it's very sad about what happened to her. Lots of depressing questions with you guys. So anyways, the question coming from this dude asking, who would you pick, Team Klenny or Team Klook? Well, you forgot the best team ever, which is Team Klain. Yes, Clem plus Jane. But if I had to choose between those two, you know, it would be Team Klenny, because, you know, obviously Clem knows Kenny a bit better. But in reality, I would pick Team, you know, Clem plus Jane, because just seeing how they were taking out the walkers in episode 4, they'd make a badass team. So definitely, I'm with Jane and Clem. The next one coming from this guy, if you had to choose between saving Kenny or Jane, who would you pick? Now, Kenny, he was an awesome dude. He took an eye for me, he protected me a little bit. Then he yelled at me for killing his girlfriend. Indirectly caused, okay? So, definitely, you know, Jane, she respects me. She thinks I'm able to survive, and she has faith in me a little bit. So, you know, I would definitely save Jane. I'm guessing you aren't pretty shocked by that answer, are you? All right, one from Carver asking, what is your goal in this challenge? The problem with that is that I don't really have a goal. I have no type of goal with this channel. I'm just doing what I do now, which is predictions and mod videos. The reason behind that is that I do not have a good computer. I have a laptop, and it's god awful. And I just happen to, you know, just do predictions, and people actually like them, so that's why I'm doing them. But I can say that I do have plans for this channel. I do have plans. I want to try out some new things. Probably not too much, because, you know, change isn't really what I'm looking for. I want to stay with what I'm doing. I want to stay true to my Telltale Games channel. But I do want to play other games that I am interested in and do other stuff. So once I get a better computer that can actually handle, you know, some good games and actually record them, I'll actually do some more stuff and see how that actually works out. So no plans yet, but well, no goals yet, but I do have plans that I'm thinking about. So once I make some, plan, once I get my plans all started out, I'll make some goals. Okay, so question coming from Clementina Everett. I think I answered this somewhere else, so you might already know. If they made a choice, say, who would you go with, Jane or go with Lee if he was alive? Now, problem with that is that, yeah, Lee, he taught me, he kind of raised me a little bit, taught me everything he knows, and he was an overall great caretaker. Now, I do really appreciate Lee for everything, but obviously, Clementine's growing up, she can protect herself now. So basically, Lee wants to protect Clementine, but he don't have to anymore because Clementine's like, she's getting older, she knows how to protect herself and everything. So Jane, she knows that. She knows Clementine's smart, she wants to teach her new things and let her learn some survival skills. So I would definitely go with Jane. Wow, shocker, but I have reason behind it because Jane, I'd be a survival partner with her. We can just, be like a two-man group. That'd be awesome. So definitely would go with Jane. I'm sorry, Lee, you taught me everything you know. You care for me, but Jane is a new era of survival now. Okay, so simply me again asking, what is your opinions on Becca? I really hate her. I don't like her. Like in like what's called 400 Days. I did not like her at all. She just plays like she's a hard person, like she's also tough. But then, she has a lot of opinions on stuff. She just don't know how to be quiet. And I was hoping that in, season 2, episode 3, I saw her, I was like, hey, it's Becca. And hopefully she changed. But nope. I was like, she talked about Clement, talk about Sarah. I was like, nope, she's still a bitch. So I don't like Sarah. I don't like Becca, I mean. She's just terrible, and hopefully, I don't have to beat her up. Okay, so Patrick asked a few questions. Who would you save if you mix it up? Bonnie or Sarah? Definitely Bonnie, because Sarah don't know how to handle herself. She has panic issues, and therefore she wouldn't really be fit for this world, as Jane said. Mike or Luke? Do they even a choice, man? Okay, Mike, definitely the Mike. Luke really just, he touched Jane, but that ain't the only reason, okay? He messed up by, touching Jane, and he didn't fend off the walkers like he was told, so he does not listen to people that much. And he argues with Kenny a lot, so definitely Mike. Kenny or Jane? I already answered this. Jane. Rebecca or Nick? I hate Nick, so definitely Rebecca. I like Rebecca. She actually lightened up in the last few episodes, and I really do care for about Rebecca more than I care about Nick, so definitely Rebecca. Rebecca's more of a mom type, but then Nick is more like a careless, not careless, but a Ben 2.0. So I'm 100% with Rebecca. Okay, so I had to put in this unfair question by the cool cucumber kid. He asked, what if Kenny had the baby and was surrounded by walkers, and then we have Jane. Now you make this so unfair. You put two against one. Okay, Jane or the baby and Kenny. Now I would be a total asshole if I did not, say the Kenny and the baby. So I would have to choose Kenny and the baby because the baby, I had to take care of the baby for Alvin, and Jane. Sorry, but Kenny and the baby are two people, and you made this so one-sided, man. So one-sided. But if I was an asshole, I would definitely go for Jane again. You people are evil sometimes. So next question coming from Harry asking, did you enjoy playing season 1 more than season 2? To be honest, yes. I think season 2 is great. I really love it. But season 1 was a masterpiece. What? Masterpiece, okay? It was just perfect and all standing. I don't really care what they say. Every single episode was great for that season. Now, on season 2, it's still great. I really do love it. But the problem is they're keeping it at 90 minutes. The episodes are shorter than season 1. And the choices don't matter, man. I haven't had, barely any impact to the story, no character development, nothing, no hub. So, season 2 is lacking in content, but otherwise that story is just great. I love the season 2 story, but I do love season 1 way more than season 2. Okay, so next question coming from Laser. Do you think Tavia's group will return? Okay, so I hope to God they make some use of the 400 Days characters. On Twitter, they were like, hey, play 400 Days before you play this episode because they will have impact. They haven't had barely any impact at all. They were just shown in episode 3. They weren't even in the episode 4 files, and they haven't been used at all. Telltale, what are you doing? I want to see Vince. I really, really want to see Vince, but you are not making any use of those characters. So I really hope so, but if not, then I hope Telltale makes them more important in season 3. So, please, Telltale, make some use of them now, or save them for season 3. And the last question comes from this dude. Do you think there's a possibility that Lee survived? Hell no. That is all. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys did enjoy, leave a thumbs up. And if you guys want a part 3 for whatever reason, Q&As are actually pretty fun. You know, I get to actually let out some of my problems and, you know, say some stuff that I normally wouldn't say in other videos. So, if you guys want me to do more Q&As, if you guys want another one, whenever I can, I'll definitely do one again. You can put some questions down below. I'll try to answer as many as I can. I think I had about 20 pictures of answers. So I probably answered more than 20 this time around. So thank you all for watching. If you guys did enjoy, leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I do Telltale stuff all the time. You can come and check me out. And I'll catch you guys later. I'm out.